We will talk about the fixing of the Voyager 1 thrusters, but before that, let's take a look at the long-lived mission, which brought worldwide excitement not only because of its 11 scientific instruments, but also due to its famous golden record filled with information to communicate humans' existence, diversity, and curiosity to any potential extraterrestrial civilization that the Voyagers could find along their path. Both Voyagers launched in 1977 to conduct close-up studies of Jupiter and Saturn, study the Saturn rings and the larger moons of the two planets, all this in 5 years. Power and fuel permitting, the mission could extend longer and achieve other objectives. Fortunately, that is what happened, and the original two-planet mission became a four-planet mission, and their five-year goal stretched beyond 48 years. Within the first 12 years, Voyager 1 and 2 explore all the giant outer planets of our solar system and 48 of their moons. After completing these objectives, both the spacecraft continue their journey toward the interstellar space more than 30 years after launch. While in the solar system, actually when visiting Jupiter, both spacecraft took about 52,000 pictures of the planet and its moons. From these images, astronomers understood critical physical, geological, and atmospheric processes in the planet and in its moons, and also in the magnetosphere. They discovered for the first time ever active volcanic activity on another body in the solar system, this case on the moon Io. From the Saturn encounters, we learned that the atmosphere of this planet is almost entirely hydrogen and helium, and that it has winds blowing at high speeds. The Voyagers also saw for the first time aurora-like ultraviolet emission of hydrogen at mid-latitudes and auroras at polar latitudes. After Voyager 1 visited Titan, Saturn, one of Saturn's moons, its path bent 35 degrees northward out of the ecliptic. This is the plane where the planets in the solar system orbit. This path took the spacecraft on a direct course outside the solar system at a rate of about 320 million miles per year. Voyager 2, on the other hand, continued its journey to Uranus and Neptune, taking images of five of the largest moons of Uranus and detecting 11 new moons. It also uncovered fine details of the previous known rings and discovered two new ones. After visiting Neptune, Voyager 2 also headed out of the solar system, this time diving below the ecliptic plane at an angle of about 48 degrees and a rate of about 292 million miles per year. In this next stage of their mission, Voyager passed through the so-called termination shock in December 2004 and Voyager 2 in August 2007. The termination shock is actually the boundary of the sun's influence, where the solar wind slows down abruptly, dropping from supersonic speeds to less than the speed of sound. In the next phase, the Voyager explored the heliosheath, the outer layer of the heliosphere that is still dominated by the sun's magnetic field and the particles in the solar wind. And finally, on August 25, 2012, Voyager 1 entered the final phase, the interstellar space, at about 111 billion miles from the sun and becoming the first human-made object to do so. Voyager 2 crossed this boundary on November 5, 2018. After 40 years, Voyager is about 15.5 billion miles from Earth, while Voyager 2 is about 13 billion miles away. The mission is still measuring the magnetic field, particles, and the plasma waves in interstellar space, sending us real-time information every day for 6 to 8 hours periods. The Voyager mission, of course, will continue studying the interstellar material as long as it can produce enough power for the instruments to work and fuel for the thrusters to keep the antennas in this spacecraft aligned with NASA Deep Space Network, or DSN, which is a set of three large antennas in the US, Spain, and Australia that gather data and send commands to the spacecraft. However, another problem threatening the end of the mission is the clogging of the thrusters over time, rendering them unusable. Although each spacecraft has spare thrusters, Voyager 1 has used the backup rotation thruster since 2004, when the main rotation thruster stopped working after losing power to two small internal heaters. But after 20 years of using the spare thrusters, the NASA JPL team is concerned that they will become completely clogged by the fall of 2025. With this issue to resolve, the NASA JPL team re-examined the 2004 thruster failure, and they decided to attempt to repair them by resetting the heater switch to the on position and seeing if the heaters could function again, thereby allowing the main roll thrusters to be reactivated. To make things more interesting, they were also facing with an 11-month shutdown of the only antenna that could uplink the commands, the Deep Space Station 43 antenna in Canberra, Australia, that it was going to be upgraded. So the team had to scramble to plan the reactivation of the roll thrusters by May 4, 2025. Without waiting until the last minute, on March 20, 2025, the team got the star trackers pointed as precisely as possible in Voyager 1. They sent the commands to turn on the dormant roll thrusters and then tried fixing and restarting the heaters. Because of the current Voyager's distance, they had to wait 23 hours for the signal to travel from the spacecraft to Earth. However, within 20 minutes of gathering the data, the team saw that the temperature of the thruster heaters raised dramatically, and they knew they had succeeded. With the roll thrusters back online, we can expect the Voyager mission to continue gathering unprecedented information that will help us to understand better the material that is between the star, the material in our galaxy. This is until the 2030s, when the power that the Voyagers will be producing won't be enough for the antennas to communicate with us. If you like the information in this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and follow me.